Hillcrest families. My name is Ms. Cabrera and I'm the principal here at Hillcrest, and I just wanted to say welcome. I wanted to invite you to take a tour, a virtual tour of our campus and get to know our different programs that we offer here. We have our dual language program, which the students get to learn English and Spanish. And then we also have our wonderful music magnet program. The students get to learn music and also play instruments. So we have a lot of different great things going here at Hillcrest. So take some time, explore our school, visit our website at hillcrestdrive.org. If you have any questions, please give us a call or reach us. We're always here to help you. So right now, to give you more information about our magnet program is Ms. James, who's our wonderful magnet coordinator.
Future parents and Hillcrest scholars. My name is Miss James. I am the music magnet coordinator here at Hillcrest. I would like to take this time to introduce to you our magnet team. Here at Hillcrest, we have one class per grade level. So without further ado, I would like to take this time now to introduce the wonderful teacher of our first grade musicians.
Hi, my name is Miss Axelrad, and I am the first grade music magnet teacher at Hillcrest. I'll be going into my seventh year at Hillcrest, and I absolutely love it there. And I'm excited to talk to you about the music magnet program because it's a really amazing program. I'm so happy to be a part of it and happy to share that with you. I'm really big on making sure it feels like a safe and comfortable space for the students. I really want them to take ownership over the room, to know that it's really theirs, and so that they can really engage in the work. I do lots of small group instruction so that I'm meeting the needs of all my students. We do small group almost every single day, and I like to think of my instruction as combining academically rigorous work with also really relevant, fun, engaging work for the students. It's hard to motivate if you're not interested in what you're doing, so I believe it's all got to be based in fun, too. Now, the music magnet program here is really special. Hillcrest has the only elementary music magnet program in all of the district, which is pretty neat. In first grade, we go to music instruction twice a week with the incredible music teacher, Ms. Negron. It's also a great program because so many studies show the benefits of learning an instrument and of music on our little ones' minds. It expands their ability to academically grow, emotionally grow, helps them to believe in themselves, and it just all around has so many benefits. And it's a great team. I love my music magnet team, and I love working for Hillcrest, and I hope that you join us. Maybe we'll see you next year in the music magnet program.
So welcome to second grade music magnet. I am Ms. Moreno, the second grade teacher here at Hillcrest Music Magnet. I've been here at Hillcrest for 5 years, and the students here in second grade not only learn all the California content standards, but they also have a music focus. Our fabulous credential teacher, Ms. Negron, teaches them how to read music notes, how to play the recorder, and they also learn vocals. And here in the classroom with me, we have a music theme every semester. For example, we just finished learning about the jazz, and this is where we do research of the history of jazz, and we research the jazz instruments, and they do reports on all the instruments of jazz. We also incorporate African American jazz musicians, and they do reports on that. So welcome to our classroom, and I hope to see you at Hillcrest next year.
Hi, family. families. My name is Miss Miranda, and I'm the third grade teacher within Hillcrest Drive Elementary's Music Magnet program. I've been teaching at Hillcrest for 4 years now, and I love teaching within the magnet because I really get to see my students develop this beautiful identity as a musician over the course of their time within the magnet, and that's been really lovely to see students develop. A typical day in room 22 starts off with scholars fist bumping, giving hugs and high fives to one another as they first come in the morning. We have breakfast together in the classroom, and then we engage in morning meeting where we all gather on the rug together, and we also do a lot of restorative justice circle approaches, and that's the time where students get to share about their home lives, share about their feelings, and it really allows us to develop a sense of community and a sense of family within our classroom. So that's a really big and important piece for us in room 22, and that's something we engage in every day. And after we finish circle, we go on to CGI-based math practices, and CGI stands for Cognitively Guided Instruction, and it's really focusing on students developing their identity as mathematicians through a lot of story problems and different ways that they can engage in real-life math practices. After that, they have some time for recess, a nice break outside. Then we come back in and do our literacy instruction. And for us, literacy looks like word study, it looks like reader's workshop practices, and we also use the benchmark curriculum. Also during that time, we do literacy small groups that further helps them differentiate for different reading levels that we have in our classroom. And typically, this is the time of the day where students will join Ms. Negron for their music classes in the music room. So they'll go in groups of about 5 or 6 based on the instrument that they're playing with, and twice a week they'll go for about 30 minutes over to the music room where they can engage in music instruction with her, and then we make up the work whenever they come back. And then we have some time for lunch and recess, and on our way back from lunch and recess, we always engage in some mindfulness, meditation, and sometimes even yoga practices within our classroom to calm our bodies down so that we are refocused and ready to go for the second half of our day together. And then we engage in writer's workshop where we build students' identity as writers and work on our writing stamina too. And one of the last things that we do is we gather back on the rug at the end of the day, and that's a time for students to engage in sharing shout outs where we can celebrate our teammates for all of the positive choices that they made that day. And then we say our goodbyes and head home. So that's what a typical day in room 22 looks like for us. And for me, since our new music teacher, Ms. Negron, has begun to work at Hillcrest, it's completely transformed our Music Magnet program. She has amplified our program and just brought us to a whole new level of music instruction. My students are super engaged in her class and they love going to music with her. We have grown exponentially in their abilities as musicians, and she really cares deeply about empowering our students as musicians and the amount of hard work and dedication and devotion that both my students have developed because of her. The way that she encourages and pushes our students has been really powerful to see. And every year, one of my favorite parts about being a Music Magnet teacher is watching the end of year culminating performance. And as a parent, that can be something that is a big highlight for you as well. But to see the amount of work that our students have put into that performance and also our Music Magnet teacher, Ms. Negron, it's really powerful to see students own their show in such a beautiful way. So that's one of the big highlights for me. Always brings tears to my eyes, and I know you'll love it too. So that's kind of us in the magnet, and I want to thank you for your interest in Hillcrest's Music Magnet program. I look forward to meeting you and your scholar hopefully this fall, and I hope that you stay safe and stay healthy. Again, my name is Miss Miranda, and I'm the third grade teacher within the Music Magnet program. Take care.
Hello, my name is Miss Mays, and I teach fourth grade at wonderful Hillcrest Elementary Music Magnet. Here at Hillcrest, music rules the school. I know because it's been my pleasure to teach a wonderful group of fourth grade scholars at Hillcrest Music Magnet. As always, I take pride in promoting education and academics through the arts. In education, rich in music can improve academic performance. Studies show when music is part of the curriculum, students learn even better. So I hope to see you real soon at Hillcrest Music Magnet. Magnet. Bye.
Hi, I'm Mr. Butler. I'm the fifth grade music magnet teacher. I teach the general education component, which includes language arts, math, science, social science, PE, and art. The students access the content in a variety of ways in my class, which include lessons, assignments, activities, reports, projects, and performances. It is here where we make the final preparations for middle school. The students will also receive excellent instruction in music for the instrument of their choice. There are also other resources that are provided to ensure our students' academic success. So, we would love to see you join our team, our family, here at Hillcrest Elementary Music Magnet.
Hi, families. Welcome to Hillcrest Elementary Music Magnet Program Virtual Tour. My name is Ms. Negron, and I'm the music teacher for the Magnet Program here. I've been teaching for, it's going to be 17 years, and this is my second, I just finished my second year at Hillcrest. The focus of my program is to get the students to play instruments as early as possible. So that means that they start as early as first grade. They start to play the xylophone, also known as the melody bells, which is this instrument right here that you see. Students learn the difference between high notes and low notes. They also learn the difference between short notes and long notes, quarter notes, half notes, things like that, so that they're able to start to recognize rhythms on the melody bells. In second grade, we learn how to play the recorder. So they not only know the difference between music notation and different rhythms, but now they start to learn how to use those combinations and put them together to create those different notes on the recorder. They also learn how to read the music on the music staff. This is something that they'll learn and also use throughout the years as they practice their musicianship. In third through fifth grade, they start to choose their instrument that they want to play. I have some of the instruments here. We have a clarinet, we have trumpet, we have violin, we have percussion, we also have flute, and we have trombone as well that they can choose from. And so I introduce the instruments to the students, and then they get to choose, and they'll play that instrument for the rest of the school year. I see them in those small groups, depending on the instrument that they pick. I see them for 45 minutes twice a week, and that's how they start to start their practice and things like that. Now keep in mind, the magic doesn't happen in here. It happens at home when you practice every day, 10 minutes a day. That's super, super important. And it doesn't sound like a big deal, like it's only 10 minutes, but it really does make a big difference. There's no need to worry about having to purchase these instruments because the school provides the instruments along with the music books. Along with instrumental instruction, the music magnet students also receive 1 hour of instruction in music theory, music history, and vocal instruction. And this happens during whole group instruction when they come to me once a week. We perform about 4 to 5 times during the school year. Our shows include Back to School Night, Latino Heritage, our holiday concert, Black History Show, and finally our spring concert at the end of the school year. Parents and families, you are invited to all of these performances, and they really are something special to see, especially the end of the year concert where the students get to showcase everything that they've learned throughout their time in the grade level that they're in. My favorite part about this whole process is seeing the creativity that is awakened within the students. I can see their eyes go from the hesitation of picking up the instrument for the first time at the beginning of the school year to the confidence that they feel at the spring concert at the end of the year, and they're feeling like, yeah, I did that, you know, and that's something really special to see. I can also see how they start to experiment with music themselves. And some will come in here and they'll play around on the piano, which, by the way, is also an instrument that we offer to learn how to play. They'll come in here and try to figure out the notes on the piano of like their favorite song that they might know or want to learn how to play. And then they'll come to me and they'll say, Ms. Negron, can we play this song for the end of the year concert? And I'll say, sure, I'll give them the music and I'll say, but you have to try to figure out the notes on your own. And that sparks a motivation in them to come to me every day, you know, day by day, and they learn the song slowly, measure by measure. And every note that they learn, it's this huge accomplishment that they feel. And you can see that in their eyes. You can see it in the way that they start to play the instrument. And that to me is my favorite thing about this whole process. I hope that you join our family here at Hillcrest for the 2020-2021 school year.